An Android Studio project's files and other assets are displayed in the project window. It appears by default on the left. You can make the project window open and close in a number of different ways. There's a tab on the left, and when you click it, it appears and disappears. You can go to the menu and choose View, Tool Windows Project, or you can press the associated keyboard shortcut that's displayed on the menu. That's Command 1 on Mac. Or you can move the cursor down to the lower left corner and hover the cursor over that icon, and you'll see a list of popular tool windows appear. And you can choose Project from there. The project window offers a number of scopes. Each scope is a different way of looking at your project. The default scope is called Android, and it shows you all the files and folders that you typically use when you're doing active development. There's a manifest directory, but that's not a real directory. It's something called a virtual directory, and it's where you find your Android manifest.xml file. There's a directory named Java, and that's where you'll find all of your code files. You'll find three different categories here. The primary one, with no notation at the end, is where you find your actual application code. And then there are two other directories that contain testing code, one for Android framework testing and one for unit testing that doesn't depend on the Android framework. The RES directory contains your resources. Those are graphical files known in Android as drawables, XML layout files, other graphics that are typically used for your app launcher icon, and the values directory that contains various resources. Now, the Android scope isn't really showing you how your files and folders are organized on disk. To see that, pull down this menu and choose the project scope. And this will show you the organization on disk exactly as it really is. There's a .gradle directory and a .idea directory. Those are hidden in the Android scope but visible here. And these contain files and folders that you typically don't have to work with unless you're getting into more advanced Android Studio management. There's a directory for each module, and by default, a new application has just one module. And under that, a source directory that contains all of your Java or Kotlin files, and that same resource directory. There's another Gradle directory here that contains essential files that you typically don't have to work with. Now, let's say you wanted to find a file in this window. And for this exercise, it doesn't matter what scope you're in. I'll use the Android scope. And now I'll go back to my main activity file. And I'm going to move the cursor up here and click this icon labeled Select Open File. And that will open the tree and show me exactly where the file can be found. The project window gives you a number of different ways to look at your files and folders, and it's typically where you access everything you need while you're doing Android development.